science explorers, it's Justin again. Since we've been filming all of these plants, I gotta admit, they've really been growing on me. But I've been wondering, why do some plants form flowers while others don't? We've seen a few plants that never form flowers, so how do they live without them? Well, today we're gonna investigate how different types of plants grow. The community garden is a great place to observe plants in different stages of their life cycles. A life cycle is a series of stages that living things go through as they grow. We'll start with flowering plants. Thinking back to what we know about flowers, what do you think the first stage of a flowering plant's life cycle is? All flowering plants start out as seeds. These pumpkin seeds can't grow right now, but with some help from a gardener or the right environment, they can be. What do you think these seeds need to start growing? Mia has been taking care of some pumpkin plants in the garden and recording their growth. Mia, when did you plant your pumpkin seeds? She says she planted them in May, right in between spring and summer. What is it about this time of year that helps seeds grow? Spring and summer bring warmth, which helps the seeds wake up. Do you remember the three ingredients needed for photosynthesis? The seed will need those too. Take a minute to pause and recall those ingredients at the bottom of the first page of your field notes. Did you remember the ingredients? They're water, sunlight, and air. But there is one last thing the seed will need, some space. If it's too close to another seed, it might feel too crowded to sprout. Mia, do you have some sped up footage of these seeds after you put them in the soil? Wow, what do you see coming out of the seeds here? The roots. And if we look above the soil, we can see a tiny sprout starting to form. This stage is called germination, the process of a seed or spore growing into a plant. Since Mia made sure this seed had warmth, water, sunlight, air, and space, it was able to germinate into a seedling. A successful germination will bring the plant to the growth stage. For flowering plants, like this one, we sometimes call this the seedling stage. Now the plant will keep growing bigger and bigger as long as it continues to get the right resources. How do you think we can tell when the plant has grown to the next stage of its life? What's changed about this pumpkin plant? A flower has formed. The flowering plant has reached its flowering stage of life. The plant is ready to make more of itself or reproduce. Do you remember what flowers need in order to reproduce? Ooh, look! Our pollinator friend is back. To reproduce, the flower needs to be pollinated. Once a pollinator, like this bee, visits the flower, the plant will be pollinated. We call this the pollination stage. Do you remember what flowers do after they've been pollinated? Look what we have here. The pollinated flower grew into a pumpkin, the fruit of this plant. If you've ever opened up a pumpkin or a squash, you might have noticed how its insides are absolutely filled with seeds. We can collect the seeds and roast them to eat, or plant them and begin the life cycle of a new plant. Either way, once a plant has created fruit and seeds, it has reached the final stage of its life, seed production. So, flowering plants have six stages of their life cycle: seed, germination, growth, flowering, pollination, and seed production. Now that we've seen how a flowering plant lives out most of its life cycle, let's go see how some non-flowering plants grow. Oh, it's a little dark in here. I wonder how these plants get enough sunlight to grow. Whoa, do you see all those tiny particles? They look like dust, but they're actually spores. Non-flowering plants release these microscopic bits into the air. Let's find a spot where some spores have landed. A fern sprout is starting to form here. Spores must be like the seeds of non-flowering plants, the part that helps them reproduce. That means spores are the first stage of a non-flowering plant's life cycle. If it gets the right mixture of resources, it will germinate and then move on to the growth stage. Ooh, look how this fern sprout is unfurling. It has long, feathery leaves called fronds. The fronds spread out to be long and wide as the plant grows. That must help them soak up sunlight in the shady forest. Since these plants don't grow flowers, how can we tell when a fern has reached the next stage of its life cycle? Mia, can you zoom in closer on these fronds? See the little dots forming underneath the leaves? Those must be the spores. This is our sign non-flowering plants have reached the spore production stage. I guess since they don't have flowers, they don't need a pollinator's help to reproduce. Remember the spore cloud? Now the fern will spread out the spores and start the life cycle of new ferns. This is the last step of its life cycle, spore release. So, non-flowering plants go through 5 stages in their life cycle: spore, germination, growth, spore production, and spore release. How are these stages different from flowering plants? Well, let's take a look at the stages for each and see what's different. Flowering plants begin as seeds, and non-flowering plants begin as spores. Then they both germinate and grow. But after that, our flowering plants will flower, and those flowers need the help of a friend to pollinate. Last, they will form seeds. After growing, non-flowering plants will produce and release spores all on their own, without the need for a pollinator. Mia, what's wrong? It's your pumpkin plant. Let's take a look. Oh no! The pumpkin looks ripe, but the leaves don't look so good anymore. They're getting all brown and wilted. Oh, it's not your fault, Mia. I'm sure you were taking perfectly good care of your plant. See, some plants, like this pumpkin plant, only live for one growing season, and it's up to the seeds to keep the cycle going. Other plants, like trees and ferns, can survive without much care for years and years. Let's look at one more plant in the community garden and see what we can figure out about its life cycle. Can you tell what kind of plant this is? It's a tomato plant! Take a look at your field notes and, from what you can see here, determine if the plant is flowering or non-flowering, and what stage of life it's in right now. So, did you guess flowering or non-flowering? If you said flowering, you're right on. Where are the flowers on this plant? Yep, those yellow guys are the flowers that will eventually form the tomato fruits. What stage of life is this plant in? It has flowers, but does it have anything else? Yes, it has baby tomatoes. Seeds will grow inside these, so this plant is in its seed production stage. Now we know a lot more about the life cycles of plants. Plants have different life cycles depending on whether they're flowering or non-flowering, and they give us a lot of clues to tell us what stage of life they're in. Thanks for joining me today. Remember, the wildest discoveries are yet to come. Until our next journey, science explorers! Hey!